Hey guys, Vampiron 20 back again with some crazy news because Microsoft has officially announced, this is official by the way, that the new future Call of Duties will be coming to the Nintendo Switch. Phil Spencer himself tweeted on Twitter not that long ago that Microsoft has entered into a 10-year commitment to bring Call of Duty to Nintendo following the merger of Microsoft and Activision Blizzard. Microsoft is committed to helping bring more games to more people however they choose to play. My first thought when I thought this was like, how is it going to run on the Nintendo Switch? That immediately I was like, okay, the Nintendo Switch, that would be cool, but currently with the Switch that we have right now, how is it going to run the new, you know, Call of Duty games? And with that being said, I'm not the only one thinking about that because Charlie Intel on Twitter also says when he spoke to a Call of Duty developer a few years back, they stated that the, you know, Call of Duty 2019 engine wouldn't even run on the Switch. So he's not clear how Microsoft intends for this to happen. And I agree. How can this even happen? Don't get me wrong. I'm hoping there's a new Nintendo Switch coming out very, very soon because I think it's time. We all thought the Nintendo Switch Pro would have been here by now. Instead, we got the OLED model, which I currently have not purchased yet because I'm holding strong. I am waiting until the new and improved powerful Switch comes. That's what I'm going to buy. I'm not going to get the OLED screen. I could care less. I play in dock mode as it is already. Now, the reason why Microsoft is doing this, and we already have a 10-year plan with Nintendo and it's already been agreed to, is they're trying to get Sony on board. Sony is the big thorn in Microsoft's side when it comes to this deal with Activision Blizzard. Sony doesn't want this to happen with Microsoft. They don't want Microsoft to buy it out because they're afraid Call of Duty is going to go away and they're no longer going to be able to have it on their platform. Now, it's already a 10-year deal for Nintendo and they offered the same deal to Sony. Sony has decided either not to accept it or they haven't even entertained the idea yet because Microsoft has stated that they are eagerly waiting to sit down with Sony because they have the same 10-year, you know, commitment that they want to give to them. And right now, I don't think Sony's playing ball. So leave a comment below and let me know, do you think Sony's just being, you know, butthurt, big crybaby, and they don't want to do this 10-year deal? Or do you think they legitimately have concerns that once this 10-year, you know, this 10-year deal is up, they're just going to pull the rug underneath of them? What I think is going to happen, this is just business. This is the way business works. What I think is going to happen is after the 10-year, you know, deal, they're going to reevaluate it and they're going to ask for more money. That's just how business works. If you want Call of Duty on your platform, you're going to have to pay for it. And if Microsoft owns Activision Blizzard, you're going to have to, you know, pay Microsoft. It's all business. It's all money. That's what makes the world go round. It's capitalism, baby. So that's just how it is. So I feel Sony should just sit down with Microsoft, get that 10-year plan going so at least you know you're good for the next 10 years. And then after the 10-year contract is up, you can reevaluate it just like any other contract. I'm super happy that Nintendo and Microsoft have this relationship together to where they can work together and try to bring games to gamers. That's what it's all about at the end of the day. So the fact that Nintendo and Microsoft are kind of like joining forces is amazing. Why doesn't Sony want to get on board is beyond me. It makes no sense at all. Please, Sony, think of your customers first. Leave a comment below and let me know. What do you guys think? Do you think Sony should just pony up and play ball and sit down at the table and say, okay, let's sign this 10-year agreement and then just reevaluate it 10 years from now? Or do you think they actually have a case and they should hold off because they're afraid that maybe after the 10-year, you know, agreement's over, you know, maybe Microsoft's going to say, nah, it's just going to be a Microsoft exclusive now. And it's just Microsoft's plan to overtake the gaming, you know, industry. What do you guys think in the comments below? I'm dying to know. I feel like they should just sit down and agree to the 10-year deal because that's just how business works. That's pretty much all for right now, guys. And as always, there'll be more to come shortly, guys. Thanks again. To help out the Van Buren 20 channel, you can now press the new thanks button YouTube just rolled out. By pressing this button, it now allows you to donate to your favorite content creator so you can show your support. Don't forget, you can also show your support by pressing the join button that makes you become an exclusive member of the channel that gives you access to exclusive emojis that you can use in the live streams. Thank you guys so much for watching my videos, and as always, there'll be more to come shortly, guys. Thanks again.